Hey guys, Kosher here, and welcome back to another Diecast review. Now today we're reviewing Chase Racelott, the next gen Vitoline. Very excited to review Chase. He's probably one of my most favourite cars at the moment that's currently out due to the metallic foil, although I do have a slight problem with it. As you can probably see where my finger is, what's happened to mine, but that's not a big issue. And obviously I've got James Air Cleaner, the first Cars 1 Vitoline we can compare to, and Brickyardly to compare to as well. Definitely reviewed Brickyardly, don't think I've reviewed James Air Cleaner, so I'll link somewhere up here to Brickyardly. But these two, as we always do when we compare, can drive off for now as we are reviewing Chase. Now he is the sort of likeness of Chase Elliott, there you go, nearly forgot his name, that's why they changed the number, which you're going to need these two back, from 61 to 24, as you can see, because Chase Elliott's number was 24, like I said about Bubba Wallace, which is Bubba Wheelhouse in Cars, that's what his number was, 6, just like Chase Racelott's number, or Chase Elliott's number was 24, but is now 9, like his dad's Bill Elliott, so a little bit of NASCAR history for you there, a little bit of knowledge. And so, you know, once again, it kind of doesn't relate anymore, but it's still cool nonetheless. So he actually voices him as well. But I'm not sure if you pronounce it Chase Racelott or Chase Racelott, because there's no A, so maybe it's Chase Racelott. So, but I've always pronounced it the other way, but for the sake of this video, I'll pronounce it Chase Racelott. Although for me, I always think it's the other way around. But anyway, he is one of the first next gens, I think, to come. He replaces Brickyardly in the race where McQueen crashes, so his first appearance isn't the Florida 500, it's actually before that, where on this same race McQueen crashes, which is at Los Angeles Speedway, International Speedway. So you see, like, obviously Brickyardly coming out, and they've given his number to someone new, so he is gone, never to be seen in the film again, and we're left with Chase. He is one of the best racers. He is up with Danny Swervers and Jackson Storm for most of the time, just like how Brickyardly was with Bobby Swift. So they kind of did that to contrast between the two, and how they're, you know, the sponsors are still doing well, even though they've got, you know, brand new rookie racers, they're still in the top three like they previously were. So they made the right move to hire Chase and Danny. There's not much else to say about Chase. So we're going to get right into the physical review. I don't want to waste no time. As we get to the start here, the camera's nearly going on me. We got his moustache grill with his sleek lights. Obviously Mattel can't really put the light them straight. But oh well, I'm sure if he was released again, I'll find another one. We have the two vents there as well. Now we have the foil here, and I think you guys can probably see my problem. There's another bit coming off here. There we go. Now that's also gone. So now I have a big gap in my foil, which looks slightly odd, I'm not going to lie. But we can ignore that. But that is why I find this foil annoying, because it doesn't stay on the best. And I have not done anything with this car apart from the display. But it's got a nice shine there, as you can see. We've got the Vital in there. For older... Oh my God, I can't even read that. Wow, the camera's really wobbly. What does it say on the older one? It is for older active cars. Okay, so it's like some sort of medication for it. He's got his secondary sponsors here, which read, if I can zoom in or focus, Piston Cup, Combustor, Carbon Cyber and Synergy. We've got his bright green wheels, I'm a fan of these for sure. And we've got his Lightyear tyres there. Little bit of an error on the paint here, quite a few of them have. Sadly, my Chase isn't the best quality, but not many of the next gens are seem to be good quality, as ones like James Air Cleaner, as you can see back here, is very good quality. It's got number 24 with that same pattern as we have on there, only white and grey stripe. This pattern, obviously, like I said, appears there. We've got his flush windows, because it's a Tim Treadless model on the back. We've got the white where the 24 is, because the 24 is the same colour. He's also got green eyes as well, which contrasts very well with his paint scheme. We've got like a sort of a Vitaline V back there as well. We've also got his white exhausts. And we have a little tiny line, it's very hard to see, indicating where his pit crew wear to lift him up. On the back we have his rookie stripes, a white stripe in the middle, and we have the 24 and Vitaline, which is very nice. I like the back of this car, mainly because Mattel actually managed to put the decals on correctly. We also have his lights in the same kind of thing with JP Drive and HJ Hollis, where there's like a black bit going across. The spoiler, once again, I think is unique if you have a look at it there. And it reads Vitoline again for old active cars. Also sees roof flaps. Now, something that's really cool with Chase is the fact that his design is different on both sides. So we have that, the annoying metallic, God knows why they tried to do it around there, but they did. We've got the V again and the metallic, which doesn't continue here. You'd be quite surprised to know. But we've got the 24 in white, the same as this side. We do have the same design on the bottom there. Just let it focus, there we go. These are in white and they're kind of harder to read than this, so you can just have a look at the difference there. I prefer this side because of the metallic foil, because it's actually placed on correct on this side, at least anyway, which is good. And oh yeah, I almost forgot, this is the base of him. Not that anything interesting there. But yeah, Chase is definitely one of my favorite racers we have. Sorry about that, let me move the camera back, there we go. Yeah, he's definitely one of my favourite racers that we have for sure. Now, if we compare him, we just budge him over. If you can compare him to Brick Yardley and James Air Cleaner. So as we start off, we have, I'll have to put my hands around here. Oh, nearly went. Now, first of all, the logos are massively, massively different. You have to hold them kind of like that. Very different indeed. James Air Cleaner's number was 61 before it changed to 24. So it's not really a consistent number. As you can see there, there is just no comparing the two. The colour isn't even, the colour is actually different to the original in this because it's the flat eyed variant. It's my brand new sort of less damaged one, so I wanted to show him for the video. So the colours don't match. The only thing that really matches is the white on this car and probably the slogan, as you can see. Nothing back on there. So there's pretty much no comparisons with James Air Cleaner. Whereas we bring Brick Yardley in, there is not really much comparison again, apart from the colours are very, very similar. So Brick's got more of a grass sort of, rather than a lime green, like what Chase has. He's got a happy expression there. The number, like I said, is the same. You kind of get the same-ish design here as you do here. It's just more basic on Chase, so this is, it's kind of similar in that sense. And then on the back, nope, no similarities there either. So you kind of have this little design here which is kind of implemented on this side, so you could kind of compare that, but that is pretty much all the similarities. As with most next gens, there is pretty much no comparison. So I'm going to ask you the question that I normally do, which is, which one is your favourite? Mine's gonna have to be Chase, despite this very annoying little gap that is missing in the foil. But to be honest, just looking at that in person, off the camera, I can, you know, I can probably get over that. I have to look at it in certain lights, but I can probably get over that. It's not too much of a big deal. I can always, well, I say I can always find another one, but with the distribution at the moment, it doesn't look like I will. So yeah, what one's your favourite, guys? Mine has to be Chase, followed by Brick and James, just because these two are just, they've just got a lot better design than James does. I'm not dissing him though, it's a very nice die cast indeed, and I might make a review on him in the near future. But yeah, that about does it for this review. If we pop these two in the background, then we feature him there. There we go, that's nice. That looks cool. I also just want to say, for my uploading, some of you would have noticed that I uploaded a cars commercial on Terry Cargas. I will be doing this for every car, or every racer, starting off with the stock cars from Cars 3, and I may go to the next gens, or whatever. So it's just a little, I hope you guys enjoy the little fun videos. It's just be different style adverts, and these might be more grown up, and these might be more retro style adverts. I just thought it was something original. Someone in my live stream said I should try something new. So that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm taking the words of Sally on board and I'm switching it up and I'm trying something new. So I hope you guys do enjoy those. I thought Triple Den was a good start because I can reach a little bit of a wider audience considering it started off in Inside Out. So I hope you guys will enjoy them little add-on videos to my reviews that I do. It seems to be daily at the moment, so let's try and keep that going. So I hope you guys do enjoy the content on my channel. If you do, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new, make sure to turn on the post notification bell as well. And with that said, I will see you in the next review, guys.